Aloha, everyone. Cheers. Aloha.
Sure, there is golf, laying around on the beach, and eating some great food, but Maui offers a lot for the mind and the heart.
Take a look at these views from high atop Maui, about 4,000 feet in elevation.
The volcanic soil here is what makes the Maui onion so sweet.
Maui is the center of the farm-to-table process that is integral to Hawaii regional cuisine on all the islands.
We are on our way to the Ali'i Kula Lavender Farm. This is a place that is magical and calming for the spirit. Your heart rate slows a bit and you breathe a bit deeper.
And why not? You are surrounded by lavender plants. Lavender is an essential oil known to relieve tension and pain while helping blood circulation and respiratory problems. Let's get you a little buzzed.
This is the Maui Wine Vineyard in Ulupalakua, famous for pineapple wine and some great views.
This kauri tree from New Zealand is 1,000 years old.
King David Kalakaua, known as the Merry Monarch and the last monarch of Hawaii, loved this place. They have the Maui Splash, a sparkling wine made with pineapple. Very enjoyable. It is refreshing with a touch of that pineapple taste.
The Mele is a red blend. The grapes are from California. This was well-rounded and would do great with any meat, even pork.
The Lokalani was a real surprise. This is a sparkling rosé, also using grapes from California.
Now next, head to Kepaniwai Heritage Gardens. This too is quiet and solemn, visited by many people. This is a tribute to the many cultures that immigrated here to form the Hawaii of today.
Most visitors know of the Asian influence, especially the Japanese, Chinese, and Filipinos, but Portugal and their many explorers had a big influence here too, as did many folks from the New England states.
And there's also a tribute to many African Americans that came here.
A lot of the serenity here also comes from the bamboo forest.
You have to take a walk into the bamboo forest and to experience the tranquility and beauty of the bamboo.
There were people we traveled with who fervently said they were never going to leave.